In this video, I will show you how I did the recording, mixing and mastering of a stoner rock song so you can use my techniques in your own mix. I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Before we start, please subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you know when there's a new video online on this channel, a channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. The song we will be deconstructing is Pusher Man by Dragneck. It's a stoner rock song, loud and powerful. I will go over the used recording setup, how it was mixed, the mastering of the song. In the background, you can already hear the song playing, and here is some more. You won't wake up until I want you to, 'cause I'm a wicked man. I'll decide what I will give to you. You're like wax in my hands. This song is part of the first recording session for the new album of Dragneck. We planned on doing the second batch of recordings around now, but due to the weird situation the world is in, that got postponed and the band decided to release the single first. Dragneck has four members with striking international names. Harm on guitar, Gijs on bass, Martijn on drums and Jip also on guitars. The band recorded together in my live room. I know from many sessions I did like this that this works really well and I use it a lot. Check out my White Noise Sessions channel for only that type of sessions. Let's go over the recording setup and start with the drums. The drums of Martijn are huge Ludwig drums. 26-inch bass drum, 14, 16 and 18-inch toms, a Ludwig supraphonic snare, Paiste and Masterwork cymbals. Big, big sound. I used Sennheiser MD421s on the toms, the snare was recorded with Röde NT5 and SM57 and I re-amped the bottom snare later. Overheads were the Neumann TLM 103 and Audio-Technica AT3525s. Really cool microphones. No room mix were recorded, I re-amped that later. The re-amping of the rooms and the bottom snare were done because the band likes to play loud and I wanted to reduce the bleed of the bass guitar and the guitars in the drum microphones. Here are the guitars of Harm and Jip. Jip used this great obscure Yamaha TA-60 amp with square speakers. Really weird, but sounds absolutely awesome. It's used on the left channel and right channel since we doubled Jip's guitar. We recorded it with the Sennheiser MD-409 and Pearl DM-9500, which is an absolute gem of a microphone. If you know any other must-have unknown microphones, let me know in the comments below. Harm used an orange AD30 top and a 2x12 speaker cabinet. We recorded that more traditionally with a Sennheiser MD421 and a SM57. That guitar is panned in the middle. Both Harm and Jip used a bunch of pedals as you can see in the images. The bass guitar of Gijs was recorded through the DI of the Ampeg SVT he uses, and we re-amped it later through the SVT cabinet. The reason for this is because for the first recordings we did together of the previous album, I used a Neumann TLM 103 on the speaker cabinet and the DI of the bass amp. But the cymbals of the drums reflected in the speaker into the microphone, so we couldn't use those recordings. We DI'd the bass and then re-amped it later. And for this recording, because we knew that, we just DI'd the bass and re-amped it later. I've pulled up the final mix for the song and I've approached it this way. First, I made sure all instruments which were multi-mic'd had the best balance of all the mix. So the two top snare microphones and bottom snare were time aligned and balanced, and then I put them through my outboard hardware, which was in this case a combination of the Warm Audio WA273 EQ going through the DBX 160A, and I committed or printed that. I did the same for the bass drum and the guitars. This way I will reduce the tracks I'm working with and I keep a better overview and focus on the entire mix. So this mix has the committed version of all tracks which went through my outboard hardware and now I'm using plugins for the final touches. Okay, let's go over the drums. Here are the drums in solo. If you listen carefully, you can still hear some bleed of the guitars. That is the glue of your mix. The kick drum was processed through the WA273 EQ and the JBL 7110 compressor, and it sounds like this. I duplicated the process, the bass and track, to have the low end and the high end separate. I timelined both tracks to have a better low end. And sounds like this. Low end. High end. Both bass drum tracks are routed to its own bass drum bus, which has a gate to make the sound a bit tighter and saturation to have a more constant attack. The committed snare has a bit of reduced attack and sustain, again to make it a bit tighter. I'm using the Alesia envelope for that. Sounds like this without the envelope. And with the envelope. And next up are overheads. The overheads were compressed with my BSS DPR 402 hardware unit, and I used a declicker to remove some spiky transients. Those spiky transients tend always to sound a bit cheap in loud rock and metal, that's why I reduced them. It has this pretty hefty high pass going on. I only want the high end of the cymbals in this song, since this song is so dense. And then I added the plugin version of the DPR-402, which does a little bit of de-essing on the cymbals to get rid of a few frequencies which pop up in the overall mix. Overheads sound like this in solo. And then we go to ride, hi-hat and tom-tom, and as you can see, they all have been cleaned up. Let's do a little bit of the tom-toms in solo, and we come back to that later. Then we go to the reamped rooms. Okay, let's turn the rooms on and off. This makes the drums sound a lot bigger, and I reamped them, like I said, to have less guitar bleed in the microphones. Let's go to the top of the drums, and you can see these two tracks over here, drum attack and tom attack. These buses only add attack on snare and toms and glue the overall drum sound more together. I could have done it with one bus, but with these two I'm more flexible and don't have to automate as much. Let's turn it on and off. It really does a lot for the sound. This is my drum bus for the song. I added the API 550 EQ to bring out some more low-end thump and mid-range presence. And I used three compressors. The Ampressor for an overall leveling of the drums, the Decapitator for parallel attitude, and the DPR 402 for more cymbal de-essing. Does Matina approve? Sweet. Now let's get over to the guitars. Let's start out with guitar 1 Harm. Harm's guitar has been EQ'd to make some room for drums and vocal, as you can see over here. And I split the guitar in two parts because Harm plays a solo and I processed the solo on a separate track. So here's Harm's main part in solo. The solo has a stereo delay, different EQ and saturation. Does Harm approve his sound? Sweet, let's go to Yip's guitars. Here are both guitars of Yip. Let's put them in solo and play a bit. One has more mids and the other has a mid dip and more saturation. This is because it's the same amp on both channels and I want more stereo width. So you have to process the left and right channel a little bit differently to increase the stereo width. Bit more of Yip. And does Yip approve of his guitar sound? Sweet. Let's go over to the bass guitar of Gijs. The bass went, after reamping, through the Warm Audio WA273 EQ and the JBL 7110 compressor, and it really has that Ampeg SVT sound. Let's check it out. Like I said, it really has an SVT sound, but I did add in a mid-range distortion. And it sounds like this. I did that because in a mix it really helps to push the bass forward. You won't hear it in the mix when it's turned on, but when you turn off you will notice that the bass has less presence. Let's check it. So instead of EQing the bass guitar, try to add some mid-range distortion. Does Gijs like his bass guitar sound? Sweet. Now let's go to lead vocal. This is the lead vocal in solo.
You come to me with your deep red eyes, begging me for more. I must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score.
On the lead vocal I used a whole lot of compression and EQ, and in the final mix I added some de-essing in the EQ to make it fit better in the mix. Before I got the final version, I had the original vocal track and I duplicated a few times to have one track only distorted, one track really squashed and one track pretty normal, and I blended all those together to create the final lead vocal track. Okay, let's go to the backing vocal, and it sounds like this.
Pusherman! Pusherman!
The backing choir saying Pusherman is made of a few overdubs of the band members together singing in one microphone, and I tuned those tracks and I pitch shift them. The delay was added to add space and depth. Let's hear it again.
Pusherman!
Then in the mix. Okay, let's talk a little bit of the mastering of this song. Here is my mastering chain for this song. The high end of the music was compressed with my bass SSL bus compressor, which doesn't have a flexible sidechain. That's why I needed to split the audio in a low and a high bus. Then both channels are sent to the combined music bus. This was my workflow before I used the Nugent Audio Sigmod plugin, and you can check my review here. All vocals are on a separate bus, so I can make the music really loud without compromising the vocals. The vocals have their own compression and EQ, as you can see here. An API compressor, some extra EQ for de-essing, another de-esser, and some slight compressing to bring up the overall level. And finally, both vocal bus and music bus go to the master bus, where I do some compression, EQing and a final limiting. This track is pretty loud. I made it loud not to compete with other tracks, but because it sounded better. I like loud rock and metal a little bit better when squeezed in a bit more. That was my recording, mixing and mastering breakdown of the song Pusherman by Dragneck. In the description below you can find links to the song in Spotify, YouTube and Bandcamp. Okay, that's it for this video. If you liked this mix breakdown, please also check out my thrash metal mix breakdown of a song of Cannibalistic Squirrel. Please subscribe to this channel and like this video. If you have a suggestion on a video I should do to help you out, please put it in the comments. I'll see you next time. Bye!